Alright guys, what is up? JeffRodyFan here, and welcome back. Now this video is just a quick explanation of why, of my absence, of why I haven't been here, and I'm sorry for the crappy quality and the poor lighting. A lot of stuff has been going on, and, a lot of stuff down at school, cyberbullying, and I've actually been threatened, and I had to talk to the cops and everything. And also, I don't know if you could tell, but I'm on the floor right now, and you can see my room's kind of a mess because I'm in the process of moving. For those who don't know, I am in Arizona. But as of December 18th or 19th, I shall be in Illinois. Been in Arizona most of my life, since second grade, and I'm in eighth grade. I'm halfway through my eighth grade year, and I'll be moving to Illinois, so I'm leaving a lot of friends behind. It's just mainly hanging out with friends and getting through some of the stuff, but a lot of stuff has happened to where I'm kind of like losing my mind. Last year there was a girl, Michaela, who practically, or not practically, was just straight up mean to me and pretty much hated me all last year. This year she's been extremely nice, and she's one of the, I'm gonna miss her definitely whenever I leave, but she was the second person I told about everything that happened, and it's just mainly like a mental state because of all the bullying and just like hearing, like in my mind, just hearing people's voices saying it's your fault, all that stuff, and then depression pretty much. And people who've gone through it know what I'm talking about, or who have gone through it knows what I'm talking about. And you know, she's been helping me through, and she's talked to me and everything, and there's three main people that I'm going to tell you guys about who've really, really helped me out. Michaela's one of them. She's really, like I said, talked to me and helped me out. And I'm thankful, and Michaela, if you watch this, thank you. Thank you. I really mean it, thank you. And then the second person is Kyla. She was the first person to know. Now the story between me and her is there was an all-nighter at a church, and me, her, and a couple others went. And we were there, and then a Pastor Chris started talking, and first he started up funny, then he went into some serious crap that was like, holy, blew your minds and made all of us cry. And but that was really when I dedicated myself to becoming more religious, and like I started hanging out with Kyla that night, and that's when I started liking her. And that night she started liking me too, but I made the mistake of letting depression get to me, which is really, really messed up, having a shot with her. So yeah, that's what sucks. But I hurt her a lot whenever I wanted to do that, and she talked me through it, she helped me through it, she's still helping me through it. The worst part for me right now is knowing, A, that I'm moving away from her, and B, that she's with someone else. That's what sucks, but, you know, she's amazing, beautiful too, but, that's not the point. Sorry. She's helped me through a lot. Another person who's really helped me was, I think there was only actually two. It's only been two people who've helped me. Well, that's... it's not very good, but hey, that'll do. Those two have helped me out a lot. And... don't know what I could've done without them. Would've sure wouldn't be here right now. That's a fact. There's a girl by the name... her name's Samantha. And she, I like her. I don't like Kyla. No, I don't like her anymore. I've kind of moved on, but Samantha is the one I like. And she's funny, she brightens up the day, she's beautiful. And she makes me laugh every time. Like, whenever I text her, I just can't help but smiling. Every time I see her, every time I talk to her, I just can't help but smile. Talk about her, I can't help but smile. She's another, so technically she has helped me, because she's the reason why I'm still here, because she technically motivates me to keep going and keep to move on, keep going. So if you watch this, thank you. I mean, you have no idea. Of course, same things, like I'm leaving her. She likes someone else, so it's hopeless anyways. But, those are reasons why I really haven't been able to record much. But, as soon as this video is uploaded, I should be in the process of that game right there, which is Call of Duty World at War. So, and I'm just gonna go ahead and tell you guys, the video is gonna be a little different. Usually I'm playing like the zombies, or I'm just messing around in funny moments, or I'm doing actual campaign, for like Resident Evil or something like that. But I'm doing something different with the Call of Duty series. As you guys know, like Call of Duty Black Ops 2, I uploaded a buried video earlier. Sorry for that, it's kind of crappy. Getting back into the thing, because I haven't been doing this for a while, so I'm getting back into it. But I'm going to actually be doing a full Let's Play of campaign of World at War. And I'm thinking of what difficulty to do and whatnot. Probably gonna do regular, since I haven't played the game in a while, but it's gonna be fun, and I hope you guys enjoyed. But if you guys enjoyed this video, click the like button down below. If you guys have any more, if you guys want to do Q&A, I'll put my Instagram down below, or actually, I'll also add my Snapchat down below, so you guys can actually send me videos of questions. I'll be doing Q&A of that. And I think you guys will enjoy that if you guys want to send me Snapchats and all that. But yeah, comment down below any game ideas that I could possibly do after I move to Illinois. Because right now, the only games I really have is Need for Speed Most Wanted, WWE 2K15, The Evil Within, Assassin's Creed 3, of course World at War, Black Ops 2, Advanced Warfare, Resident Evil 5, and GTA. Those are the only games. Of course, I have some others that I can borrow from my brothers. I can do a Fallout 3 Let's Play. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next video. Peace out.